The issue of job cuts in the public service just won't go away for the incoming Chief Minister. Terry Mills is again trying to reassure public servants their jobs are not in the firing line. As for Labor, it still hasn't decided who will lead the Territory opposition. But one of its retiring members says Labor has no future in the Territory if it can't reconnect with the bush.
He hasn't yet been sworn in as Chief Minister, but Terry Mills was in demand by national media, again being asked if he plans public service job cuts.
That is a scare campaign that was run in the Territory.
Terry Mills has consulted the Public Service Commissioner on how to reduce the high staff turnover rate, but he hasn't ruled out using that turnover to reduce its size.
No one's going to lose their job. They're going to be strengthened in their job, but you know, you bear in mind that there may be some surplus in some areas, and the only way that would be dealt with is through natural attrition.
Senior managers will have to wait to find out if they'll be repositioned, with some reassurance.
We honour contracts.
New opposition members are moving into Parliament. Defeated and retiring Labour members are moving out, not without some cutting advice on how Labour should try to stem the bush backlash before the federal election.
Labour needs to say sorry, I think, to people in the bush. We didn't stand up to the federal government.
The federal government is defending its rebadged intervention as having created 800 jobs. Marion Scrimgeour says the jobs aren't in her constituency and Territory Labour shouldn't have supported the Commonwealth like puppets.
There was no way we needed to go forward with legislation in terms of stronger futures. Nothing was changing for Aboriginal people on the ground.
She says Labour must reclaim the left and listen to the bush.
If we don't, then we won't have a Labour Party in the Northern Territory.
The outgoing Chief Minister hasn't yet fronted the media to say if he'll remain as Labour leader or move aside for his deputy. All of the votes counted on Saturday have now been rechecked.
The counting of absentee and postal votes still coming in won't start until Tuesday, so the results in Stewart and Arafura won't be known until at least then. The final election result won't be officially declared until Monday, the 3rd of September. Jane Barden, ABC News.